It's a short time to have you on the show. Today we're talking to a couple. Now usually entertainment business, they say, is time consuming. You are in the eye of the public. You are not your own life. Everybody wants to know about you. And usually when an entertainer gets married, people give it a few years. It doesn't work, they say. The pressure on the marriage is too much. So what happens when two people in the industry get together? Can they make the marriage work? And if they have done it, what's been the magic? We're talking to a couple like that today. Now, the interesting thing about this couple, I met the lady first, and at the time, she was an artist, and he was, quote-unquote, her manager. We guess when the doors were closed, something else was happening. Because years later, it was not just all about music. Join me as we meet and greet Seyi and Azeezat Allen. It's great to have you on the show.
It's a great pleasure.
Azeezat, why are you behaving as if you were shy? When I met you, you were a young girl just trying to focus on her music. And Seyi at the time, your manager.
Imagine, you were supposed to be singing only.
I told you myself, I was reporting to my dad.
That
he was supposed to teach me music
only.
Honestly speaking, when we met, I was her manager, she was my artist.
Was that all, Seyi?
Yes, because I had somebody I was going out with.
So
I don't know whether she was going out with. I think she had somebody. I was going out with somebody.
And then, how did the management enter somewhere else?
It was until that relationship ended. And then what happened then, I lost my mom like 4 years, like 4 months after, and my life was empty, and I had to be a replacement somehow.
So Azeezat, you saw this lonely man, as your song said, is a lonely world, and you decided, well, to hold on. It in the family.
I saw this lonely man, I decided to hold on.
how did it work for you? How come? What happened?
I really cannot see. That's why I said I'm going to report him to my dad. Yes, that you were supposed to teach me music and you were teaching me something else.
What was that? Okay. I believe this is a ladies whatever.
No, I need to know. When did you stop seeing him as a manager and you began to see Seyi the man?
I really cannot see. One of the things
that I proposed.
One of the things I always say is that I just saw him as somebody who was caring to people, and then at a point I became his best friend. You know, he was telling me a lot of things. I didn't have a male friend that was that close to him. And then by the time he lost his girlfriend, I was shopping for a girl for him. You know, I was what about this one? What about this one? Not knowing that something else was in his mind.
That was a teacher. But actually, what happened was, to me, after that relationship ended, I made up my mind that the next relationship I was going to have was going to lead into marriage. I was only interested in 1, 2, 3, 4 years relationships again. So I made up my mind, you know, at that point in time, you would have made up your mind that, okay, now it's time to choose a wife, not a girlfriend. And, you know, she had finished school, and amongst other girls that were around, she's the only one that graduated and gone. I said, okay, who wants to wait for another girl that's going to get into university and be waiting? And so I just proposed.
You just proposed? When you proposed, were you thinking, I really made the right decision? Or it was a spur of the moment thing?
It was the
spur of the moment thing. Just said
no, it wasn't. I actually, there were others. Actually, there were other girls, and I actually started watching everybody's behavior. I started analyzing and strategizing, and you know, and well, she was the most qualified.
Okay, so you were the winner. So when you proposed, and said, what made you say yes?
I guess I looked at it like there was no other person, you know, for me. I really cannot say. Although I first gave him some kind of tough time, I didn't I? But I just felt
like,
yes, I did.
I can't remember.
The men never remember afterwards. But what happened was, I By that time, I had grown to, you know, care for him and all that. I was very close to him. And I had already told myself before then that one has to marry his, her friend. And this was my friend. And then I had had a couple of discussions with some people, and it was like, if you have another manager outside and you have, you go and marry somebody else, would he later give you some problems? Because, you know, the two of guys would fight. So, I mean, what he proposed was just like an answer, you know, to all these, you know, questions.
Funny enough, I thought about that too, that supposing, I've always been interested in marrying a banker, where the money is. But, you know, I thought about it several times, that supposing I marry a banker and I'll have to be doing it as ours, with female artists, not just like that, but with female artists, how will the person view it? You know ladies that always think that, hey, you're spending more time with these girls more than me and things like that. So I think it was a good decision to
Okay, now, I've always wondered, now, she is an artist and then you're her manager. She's also your wife and you're her husband. Is there a line drawn? How do you know, like, sometimes the manager is angry with the artist and they are, you know, really, really upset and all that. Is it different now that she's your wife? How do you draw the line?
It's not. It's the first thing, first and foremost, we have a working contract, a business contract, and we do business meetings. Sometimes you come to, you know, outside like this, sit down and carry papers and, you know, check papers, check spendings and things like that. So we do business apart. I mean, before this morning, while we were preparing for the interview, you know, I was like a manager to her. You know, we're wasting time, this and that, NTA, you know, I would like to waste NTA's time and things like that. So, I mean, that's the business aspect. But if that's the same way I would treat any other artist,
okay,
maybe a Sonny Nedjo or a Blackie or a Two Face, it's the same thing. I'm going to help them keep to time and things like that. So, it's not, I think it's the same. The same way I treat other artists. That's
the same way. Now, this is I know, like, some as an artist, sometimes your manager gets on your nerves. Now, the point is, when he's got on your nerve during the day and you get home, is it his way to switch and be all lovey-dovey?
No way. I always tell people that the relationship is, it's basically more of a working relationship than the lovey-dovey. But, you know, because I mess up, I have it, and there's no closing time. I don't mind him. He said he treats me the same way, but he treats me worse. Because I guess he has a point to prove, you know? So he's always like, he's harder on me than he is on other artists. But the truth is, it's more of a working relationship. There's no line drawn. And if he's annoyed with me as an artist, there's no way we'll now say we have reached house. If I venture to bring any love, I'm on my own, you know?
So it kind of overlaps.
Yeah, it does.
Now, Seyi, you know, your manager, your husband and all that, do you think, like she says, you push her more, really?
Well, sometimes I think I do, because, like she said, sometimes if she does something outside and I complain, when I get home, I'm going to go on complaining. And I'm going to go on lecturing her, like, this is the mistake you made on stage and that, but try and correct. It's possible that if you are watching a movie and she says something and I remember, I'm going to tell her again one more time. So I think those are the extra times, you know. It's all for her betterment, you know. I don't think, actually, I don't want people to hear that I'm married to her and I'm not contributing anything.
Okay.
Sometimes people think she has everything because she has me, but it's not like that. We have to work hard all the time to get to where we're going.
How has she changed your life? You know, before you were an artist under him as just a manager, you're still an artist under him as a manager and a husband. How has all that come together to change who Azeezat is?
He has added a lot of, I don't like saying this thing in front of he has added a lot of value to me. I recently started another phase of hard work, and I look at myself, I said, I'm so stunned at the kind of value that he's continuing to add to me. add to me. You know, the truth is, it's not allowing me to sit on my oars. I look at my life and like I'm like, what would I have been without this man? It's like whoever you see now is Seyi and Len. When you see Azeezat, it's Seyi and Len, because you know, the blessings. You know, that's why I want to say this. You know, he has added a lot of value to me. He has made me what I am.
Okay, now we know, Seyi, that Azeezat is amazingly talented. From the first time she came out with her single, everybody knew this was one small lady with a big voice. Yeah. So we know Azeezat the artist, but many of us don't know her intimately. But you are her husband. What are those things in Azeezat that just stands out as Azeezat, not the artist we all know?
Let me see. I have to look for it from now till tomorrow. At home, she's a good cook. At home, she cooks well. She knows how to manage small materials and do fantastic things with them. And I think that's special. You know, sometimes you get home and you cannot go to the bank at 12 and you have just 100 naira, and she can actually, you know, prepare and do something with it and get it done. So yeah, she's good. She's intelligent. She's quite intelligent, at least. He teaches me grammar most times because she's a mass comm graduate. So she helps with all those things. And she's very caring anyway. She's very caring. When I go for a hard day's job and I come back and she's at home, she knows how to manage my feet and my hands, you know, massage them and things like
wow.
That.
Wow. You're enjoying it. This is the Azeezat we haven't heard of. This is the Azeezat we're going to be soft Azeezat. Okay, we'll take a short break. Take a music video. When we come back, we'll be talking to Seyi and Azeezat Allen. I can't believe this is the Azeezat we're talking about. This same Azeezat, she's also hard on her videos. So she's a softy inside. Take a short break and we'll be back with this amazing couple. 5500, I'll make sure I take a shortcut so you don't have to wait for too long. Well, I just got to let you know, if I get caught up and go slow, don't think I'm somewhere doing wrong. No, maybe in a little while, tap ta tap ta ta da, I'll behold your charming smile. You won't be all alone, no more. Are you ready? I'm coming home. Cause I only got 5 minutes more to go. Yeah, baby, I wanna know. Alright, welcome back to the show. I'm having so much fun with Seyi and Azeezat this time, and I can't believe all the things I'm hearing. It really works when you marry somebody in the business, keep it in the family. Now, Seyi, over the years, you know, we know she's extremely talented, and I know at the time she started, there were not a lot of females in the business. Now, more and more females are coming out, and the business is blowing up. And you're doing the same thing, you're managing her, you're managing other artists. What's the financial reward like for you guys? Because this is where it's like you put all your eggs in one basket. This is the business for you people. What's the financial reward?
I would like to you, recently, yeah, there's a boom in the industry and everybody's making money, but earlier it was difficult, especially for the fact that for us, when we make money, we have to put it back. The others will make their money and buy cars, build houses, but we, you know, we are looking into the long-term side of the business. So if we get money and we have to do videos, we have to put 200k, 300k back into a video, and then we make another money, we have to put it back into the business. We have to run copies of her CDs and put it into the market. So, well, it's been wonderful. I mean, knowing that what she does pays for what she does. As in, she sings, she makes money, the business is paying for itself. And then sometimes we have to try and make money from other ends to like keep life going. But I don't know where to say, like it's been okay. Hasn't been wonderful, but it's been okay. But if it had to if it was like she had a label and she signed on to and they're spending all the money on her, that means every money she makes there's it's hers or it's ours and we have to enjoy it. But you know, it's just wise of us to put the money back into the business.
Okay. Now I know as that you perform in shows and you got some crazy hairdos, some crazy hairstyles, and I'm sure the guys are flocking around. How is it, you know, easy? Does he mind? Does he know that you're afraid somehow? Does he think, okay, let's start going home?
No. He doesn't mind. I remember a particular show where, you know, it surprisingly, one of my fans had to carry me.
Wow.
You know, like, carry me and all that. And Mama was like, that was a first. I've done a lot of things. Romance guys on stage just make my act more exciting. But you know, it was a first. I was like, the first. I look for his face in the crowd, and the guy will just, you know, it's just part. He knows that it's part of the act. I always say, I want to say this, for the benefit of upcoming girls. That a guy who doesn't trust you when you are an artist, he won't trust you even if you were a banker, you know. So, you know, he knows that it doesn't matter.
Now, I know that even though, you know, everybody has a good, like, you obviously have a good partnership, you're obviously friends, and it seems like you guys have it all locked down. But, pretend she is not here. What is that irritating habit she has? Like, if you had an eraser to erase that part of his life away,
irritating habits. We quarrel a lot. That's all. All this all you are saying is just from drink. we quarrel a lot. You know, next moment we can be like. But the thing is, I have learned. I'm not a goody two shoes or anything, but I've learned that most of the things is still the spice. You know, I am somebody who cannot sit down and allow love to just go. Fear will start catching you, or I start getting bored, and all that. So I believe that all those things are just part of what makes the relationship work.
Okay, so Shay, can we have your list?
Yes, my list. I study this topic. But for me, Shay, I think she's the worst timekeeper in the world.
I've got
okay, not in the world. Okay, not in the world. Maybe Lagos State, maybe somebody. You know, it's a fight every day to like make her do things on time. That's what I do not like about her.
What's that thing about her that Aziza just has special that you just keep loving every day? That habit that she does.
Wait, I'm not finished with it. She calls my name like 50 times in one day. I'm trying to get her to reduce it to at least twice. Call me twice a day is enough. Okay. The nice part is that anyway, each time I come back home, she's always loving that song. You know, it's always happy to know that. I mean, you're going home and you're going to meet that person. Even when we go out together and we are going back home, I'm always happy that I know that when I get home, this woman is going to pet me. So.
That okay, so apart from petting, what does he do for you?
He does a lot for me, and sometimes I pretend to be sick so that I can cook.
He cooks,
yeah, he does.
Wow,
he does. I cannot be putting all my clothes outside. He does a lot for me, should I reveal this one?
Let's discuss it first.
But one of the things that recently he actually washed my clothes and I was like, God.
That's not a big deal.
Ha! Nigerian man here.
I was like, for days I was floating. Feeling cool.
Feeling cool.
My sister.
He washed my clothes.
Yeah,
that's
really, really.
But that doesn't mean that he's that sweet.
That doesn't
sound good
today. I might do
it in another
3 or 4 days.
I think you want you to beat AK.
Okay.
That one keeps me satisfied.
That's cool. So what's the future like for the islands, Jay? What are you looking at? What are you looking at as professionally and also as a family?
Okay, yeah, okay. Soon we are setting up a label.
Okay.
We have other businesses, which, you know, this is something I like other artists to hear. We have other businesses that we do. Our music money into, so that at least we can continue. But we want to do music for the rest of our lives. The future is that 20 years from now, we are not going to change.
Mm.
But we will remain, you know, top in our business. And I want every other artist to know that all the new ones that are coming out to know that we are not going to be old school in 20 years' time. We will be newer school in 20 years' time. So we will continue to do this business. And we do other businesses aside, but music is forever with us.
Okay. Now, Azeezat, how do you feel that, you know, you were the singer in the family, you know, now he is going to be doing that? How does it make you feel?
Well, at first I felt uncomfortable, you know, because I started imagining that this guy was not going to be giving me as much attention, you know. But I've had time to, like, you know, get used to it. I'm excited about it because I want a situation where people can really be able to see this, valuing him for all the talents that has been leading all this while. That, you know, people be able to appreciate that this man truly is my backbone, you know. He sings, he just knows everything. He knows this industry like the back of his hands.
Mm.
And I want people to be able to appreciate that.
That's what we go to.
Hmm. Okay, Azeezat, you know what, I mean, people say beauty is not, it's just not just skin deep and all that. But what is that feature in Shay? What's that feature? Is it his nose, his mouth, his physique? What's that thing that when you see, you're like, my brother, this is my man. It is see the one that can be accepted on TV. Okay, is that
his hair.
Okay, what is it about his hair? Okay, I can see that it's curly. I don't understand why.
Actually, it's naturally curly.
Oh, really? Okay, so that stands him aside. We are apart from other guys. So Shay, look at Azeezat. What's that feature in Azeezat that just gets your juices going?
Well, it's her smile. She has a close-up smile.
It's super smile.
So that's what she loves about Azeezat. Okay, it was really fun hanging out with you. I feel like I just sit here all day and just have fun. You guys are an amazing, down-to-earth couple. Down-to-earth.
Can we ask you questions?
No. Show on a very romantic note. Okay, it's not an 18 and above program, but we'd like you to do something romantic. Mm-hmm. Let's think
okay,
of
it. Okay, let's
talk. No, wait.
Sing me Bea Lomo. No, not Bea Lomo.
Okay. Okay, you will do the chorus and we'll do the verse.
Yeah.
Okay, let me just sing the verse. What's that verse?
No, let me start with the chorus. You don't sing the buggy to me.
Mountains may die, rivers may dry. You may forget me, but never will I. If you're lonely, I got nothing to do. Do you remember I'll always love you? You know you defend me, I want me. You're gonna be the sugar of my tea, my duty, titi lai lai.
Thank you. Amazing couple, Shay and Azeezat Allen. It was fantastic again hanging out with you. I can't believe this blushing Azeezat. I cannot believe that Azeezat has been blushing all through. Shay, thank you so much for hosting us.
Thank you.
Here we've been hanging out with Shay and Azeezat Allen, and they have explained so many things, shared their home with us. At least we know that Shay's hair is sexy and that Azeezat's smile melts Shay's heart. Thanks for being on the show. Next week, we'll be talking to another interesting couple. And believe me, you won't want to miss that. But till then, bye-bye and be happy.
Only mama was teaching me ABC. Never told me that there would be one to fit. When mama was